start or what?
You want me to start? Turn my mic on and I'll start.
You are on.
It sounds like I'm not on. It sounds like I'm on now.
Can you hear it now?
Yes, Tim and Jay Moore here, Lil' K Kendra. This is Hittin' the 12, where we tell you some of the events going on through the week here in Niagara, plus the music going on in the clubs Friday and Saturday.
Yeah.
And plus, very special guest in here today.
In here right now.
Yeah, came a little bit
in
early,
here
but
right
hey.
Now. Super excited.
Because he's super pro, that's yeah. why. And awesome. He brings in, his mic's not on either.
Well,
you don't know what's
I
happening.
Was waiting until we introduced him.
I just did.
Well, you didn't say his name.
You say it.
Michael Chess from Figure Four.
All right. Does his
see?
Mic work?
Yes, it's on.
Check one, two.
Yeah, see?
Sounds weak to me.
You're weak.
All right.
That's all I gotta say. Everything is right.
All right.
Everything is on.
Hey, I'm just testing. You're in operation here.
I think you just can't hear.
Yeah.
Everything's falling apart.
Yeah.
Moving.
Ants,
you know,
in the studio.
Ants.
Wires falling apart. Nothing's
ants
going right.
Pants.
I'm slowly embarrassed. I'm totally embarrassed.
I know.
To have Michael Chess from the Great Figure Four in here, and everything is falling apart here. Shout outs to Rick Rose and 4680Q for taking care of us again.
Yes.
And
I'm glad we have this space, because where else would we do this? We'd be out in the cold
at a real studio
doing our videos.
Yeah.
Okay, you go find one then.
Mike Ridley, I'm gonna call you next. Giant FM, somebody.
All right, Mike Chess, Figure Four, you got a crazy event coming up with Jonesy.
That's correct.
Let's start with that. We're going to start with that. We'll come back to it because we also want to have other conversations with you because we have you in the studio. So we're just going to chatty chat, chat, chat.
Sounds good. Yeah, it's been a long time.
But
chat
let's start with the fundraiser.
Yes,
No One Goes Hungry.
Yep. We're doing a fundraiser for No One Goes Hungry with Jonesy, as you mentioned. That's April 20th, I believe, at the Ovation Ballroom.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's Port Robertson, used to be the Club Castrignano behind
okay.
The drive-in. It's a beautiful spot
Oh,
there.
Okay. Yeah. Like Highway 20.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, so the guys from the 43 North Restaurant Group, they're running it now, and they do a great job everywhere that they're involved in, including like... Johnny Rocco's and Cracker Jack's
okay.
and the Commercial Roadhouse, et cetera, et cetera. So they know what they're doing. It's mm-hmm. a great spot, and they've offered up the room for us for the fundraiser to help out No One Goes Hungry.
Yeah.
And Carrie Benvenuti is the one that heads up that No One Goes Hungry
yes.
program, and she does awesome work, too, and helps bring food to kids in high school that mm-hmm. otherwise don't have meals for the
yeah.
day. So,
now,
yeah,
does Paul Saxon, is he involved in this
yeah.
as well?
Absolutely, yeah. Paul and
the
Mark
Saxon. The
Saxon
team.
Okay.
Yeah.
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 So you've worked with them before with the other fundraisers for No One Goes Hungry?
We were here
no.
at Taps. No,
yeah.
we were.
No, it was up at... Chuck's Roadhouse and Taps. Yes.
Right.
But I remember because Shane and I were hosting at right. the one at Chuck's Roadhouse, and you and Pat came.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
That was Paul Saxon. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They've done a couple with, and Jonesy was involved as well. And then the other one was with Dwayne Gretzky,
mm-hmm.
As well as Ron Hawkins from Los of the Low.
Yes.
So,
we had
yeah.
him on, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, something like, yeah. yeah.
2 weeks
yeah.
ago, yeah, we had an interview with him. His
so
show in April showed, sold out.
It's sold out now?
Yeah,
it's oh,
sold
nice.
Out.
Nice.
Yeah, he's great.
Yeah. yeah.
So the room, like, because Paul Saxon wrote that you got to sell 500 tickets. This is a big room.
Yeah, it's fair size room. It's yeah. ballroom. Yeah.
Yeah, that's perfect.
It's a ballroom.
Yeah.
So how much are the tickets, do you know?
I believe they're $25.
Okay.
And they include your admission, your donation, a slice of the pizza from the Johnny Rocco's food truck there.
Oh, nice.
Wood burning oven
okay.
Pizza.
Oh, beautiful.
And then there's also $3,000 prizes that are included as the door prize.
Okay.
One of them is a ride in the new BB limo, which is like a 12-person Mercedes Star Sprinter limo. So
beautiful.
If you want to ride in style. And
yeah.
then there's also a weekend stay at Bob Cajun Resort up in Bob Cajun.
We're talking major prizes.
Yeah.
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 And then the guys from 43 North. Are going to put together a gift basket with a bunch of gift cards for all their properties as well. So some great prizes and decent entertainment and
yeah.
an amazing cause. So it should be a fun night.
I like the two-night stay at the Bob Cage.
I like the limo ride myself.
Where are you going to go?
Who cares?
Are you going to rent it for the Eclipse?
No, I'll take it. I'll take it straight down to the wrestling ring. That's what I'll do. I'll get out like Nature Boy Ric Flair. That's what I'll do.
If we can rig it that you guys win a prize each, you can take the limo to
Bob Cajun. Yes. Yeah. That's what somebody's going to do. Yeah.
Some takeout on the way. Yeah.
Smart. Right. There's a bunch. Oh, so of course all the sponsors: the 43 North Group, Saxton Team, Rever Realty, No One Goes Hungry, Who It's Going For, Johnny Rocco's, Commercial Roadhouse, Commercial Speakeasy, BB Limo, Bob Cajun Resort, and of course we want you to also be one of the sponsors by purchasing tickets, so that you can help No One Goes Hungry Niagara. Yeah. I think that's a pretty sweet deal.
Now, what I like about this is it's two major bands, 25 years of Figure Four, which is crazy. This could be the longest running band in Niagara.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know, man.
I don't know who's been around longer.
Yeah.
I really don't know. Haul. 25 years. I remember, I think I was in the early years of seeing you guys. My first memories of seeing Figure Four was down at the bottom of the Red Hot Chili Pepper in the basement. Yes. I was friends with Chris Burnett and Tommy Temple and Veronica. We all used to go to that crew down into the basement, and you would rock the place all night long. You would even end it on some Rage Against the Machine, which I loved. That was a common tale.
Absolutely.
Chris Burnett would wear the Rock t-shirt, like the Rock Dwayne Johnson t-shirt when he was the Rock from the first run of wrestling.
Yeah.
And that's where essentially Figure Four is a wrestling name.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. It comes from the wrestling term from Ric Flair. Yeah.
Yeah. So how many years ago was that you were at? Do you think that was a start for, do you think that's where you kind of got your name at Chili Pepper? Because you guys rocked at Chili Pepper a lot.
Well, yeah. I mean, we had the name before we played at Chili Pepper, but that was one of our first gigs, and that was definitely home base for the longest time.
Yeah.
And shout out to the guys from Chili Pepper from back in the day. Man.
Back in the day, that was a major place. And who was running security the door there? It was his name Dave or something? Dave? Yeah. Dave. Yeah. He was crazy, and I loved him too. Yeah.
I think I didn't move here until like 2022. Sorry, 2002.
Gotcha. That makes more sense.
So it's been about 22 years. So I would have missed that, but I feel like I knew who Dave was.
He also worked in Port Luzie somewhere, Port Mansion, the old Port Mansion days.
Okay. Yeah.
So
hilarious guy.
Yeah, hilarious guy. Great. Hilarious guy. He had a 2x4 in the back of his brown pickup truck and
I
ready to slug it out. Yeah,
I didn't know him that well.
Female, you can get in the door.
Every female got in the door for free.
Just give Dave a kiss.
And he knew them all. He knew them all. He was great.
Well, he didn't know me that well. I obviously wasn't a good looking girl.
Why, you had to pay?
No, I don't. I don't remember. There was at the Chili Pepper. There was a
cover for guys.
Okay.
So that I don't.
Chili
remember,
Pepper
so
used to be lined up down the road to get in. You had to get in there early. This is when clubs were clubs. This is when it was good times before internet, before any of this Facebook and everything.
We didn't even start till close to midnight.
And closing the place up. That was the good days of live music, man. Here in St. Catharines. Yeah,
I can't remember the last time I left my house after 9 p.m.
Right.
Like,
everything's moved so early now. It's like everything's moved up during COVID and it hasn't gone back. And it doesn't really work in my favor.
No, there's a lot more matinee shows. Yeah. There's a lot more, we start at 6, 7 o'clock. And
I was here early today.
I know you're used to it.
I much prefer that because then you can still get home at a good time and get a good sleep.
When you're old now.
Yeah.
That's a very responsible thing to say. But
when you're young, you get up at like 11 noon or midnight and you go out and you're up till 5 in the morning.
Well,
I still
get up at like 11 a.m.
Yeah,
but that's because I need like 12 hours in bed.
The problem for me and for us is we have to leave the house earlier to get to the show.
Yeah.
And we don't get home any earlier.
No,
you don't get home earlier.
No, you have to leave early because you have to set up.
There's about 4 encores. People want to talk to you. There's running around trying to get paid.
It's hard to leave,
Yeah.
Yeah, and you have to be there early to set up.
That's right.
And it takes a while to set up because everybody still wants to talk to you while you're trying to set up.
I would just rather stay home the extra hour and hang out with my family before I have to go at 3 a.m. They don't want anything to do.
No, they don't want nothing to do.
But at least as the lead singer, you actually show up with the rest of the guys instead of many other leads.
Yeah, that's true.
But how many lead singers show up like...
I'm not
10 minutes, 10
why would you
minutes
ask
before
the
show.
Yeah, why would you
because
ask
you know I that there's, you know, too, there's though. So yeah. many of them that are like, oh, well, I only have a microphone.
Are they going to wait that? Because I want to talk to them. I gotta figure out how to do that. Poor Uncle Bobby, Rob Carroll, he's the one that has to carry most of the gear, but yeah.
You're right, yes.
He's the keeper of the gear.
Been doing it for years, yeah. Yes, since the day I've known him. He's been carrying in the gear, and and he's happy to do it. He doesn't seem to have a problem. He's always got a smile on his face, always happy to see you, you know.
But the thing is, you know, like you guys call him Uncle Bobby, but the thing is more, he's more like the dad.
Yeah.
Because the fun uncle is usually the one causing the ruckus. As much as he causes a ruckus, he's still making sure everything is set up.
Right.
Yeah.
Everybody does their part.
He tries to corral
you. Does their part.
He also has another nickname. I'm not sure if you're aware of this one, but HR Rob is the other nickname that he has.
Human Resource Rob?
Yeah. Because
Human Resource. I was going to say His Royal Highness.
Oh. No. He's got a great sense
of humor. That's
HRH. Right.
Let's put it that way.
Okay.
Yeah.
HRH. Yeah.
He's a legend. We love him.
Aww. So figure four, is this kind of a weird question, but is this the only band you played in? Because it seems like I don't know you from anything else but figure four.
Well, I mean, 25 years, right? So this was the first band that I like sang and played guitar in.
Yeah.
I was playing drums in bands before this.
Okay. Which seems weird. I don't think I've ever seen you on the drums ever.
Yeah, well, I mean, that was high school.
Okay.
Right? So it's going way back. But so Chris Burnett was in the band Granny's Candy Jar.
Yes.
With the original guitarist.
Granny's Candy Jar?
They actually put an album out. I got the CD at home.
Oh, seriously?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, so they were great.
I did co-op it, sorry.
It was Bernie, and it was the original guitarist and bassist, right? Sean Oakes and Paul Strigno.
Sean Oakes from Black Sheep, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So they were in Granny's Candy Jar, and then their singer Dave was going away to university.
Okay.
But they had the gig lined up at the big Front 54 Labor Day Bash.
Oh,
and they
didn't
want to give up the slot.
No.
So they're like, do you want to sing and play guitar or sing or play guitar, figure it out? Like, we don't want to lose the gig, right? So I was like, yeah, I'll give it a shot. We were jamming in the basement and all the time, you know, when we'd be jamming, I'd move to the vocals or the guitar. So I was dabbling a bit, and that was our first gig.
Wow.
Labor Day 1999.
Labor Day 1999 at Front 54.
Wow.
Now Moose and Goose. We played Moose and Goose recently for a fundraiser, and I kept calling it Front 54 because they've always been good to us there.
Right.
And that's where we got our start.
Oh, it's a great music venue. Absolutely great music venue. Always has been. Yeah, Front 54. Yeah. Shout out.
Moose and Goose.
Well, Moose and Goose, yeah.
Yeah.
Now Moose I'm calling it, yeah.
I know.
Yeah. And so our tagline for our anniversary, I had a million of them that I was brainstorming, but it's so true, and I believe it. It's like, we've been going to the same party for 25 years and still loving every minute of it.
Well, for sure, yeah.
Well, I mean, Bernie, Bobby, Nick is on guitar now. He fits right in. He's awesome. I don't know if you know Nick Parasotto.
No.
Hasn't
he played a few times with you before?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's filled in, and then him and Brett were alternating for a while, and now he's in full time. Brett from By Design, who's also a great guitarist. We've been lucky to have a lot of great guitarists join us, and Johnny and Gary and Sean and everybody, right?
So many.
When you think about it, 25 years of Figure Four, that's longer than even major label bands.
And to only have had that many other guitar players.
Not too much switched out. Yeah.
Usually that happens within like a year of other bands.
Right. Yeah.
They're like, switch this out. Switch this out.
Yeah, exactly.
I wanted to ask a question about going back to the Figure Four name.
Yes.
How fast did that name come to you guys?
Well, that was actually Paul Strigno. He named it. You know, it's one of those things with bands, you kind of go through that exercise, right? Of having all kinds of names. If it was up to Bernie, it would have been called Joe Dirt.
I did not know that.
But
no.
Even worse, if it was up to me, the band was almost named Choo Choo and the Herky Jerky Dancers.
Holy shit.
So it was a bit of a mouthful. And I think Paul was on.
How do you put that on the drum kit?
Exactly.
Yes. So it
all worked out for the best. But band names are all stupid and meaningless anyway. Right?
Yeah, I like Figure Four, man. I think it catches for me.
Yeah, it has the whole wrestling thing to it.
Not that they do anything wrestling, but whatever. It's a great name.
Yeah.
It's a great name.
But it's still...
It's still figure
is that
four.
Is that a wrestling challenge that we don't do anything wrestling?
I know.
What, are you going to do something wrestling?
I
yes.
No,
we
could
do
like
the wrestling challenge.
Turn into a
we
bit
could
here.
Smash the guitar over somebody's head and start swinging chairs. Yeah, we could do that. That would be great.
Against the Italianos.
Yeah, the Italianos against
line.
Figure Four.
We'll probably have a combo yes. event.
New storyline.
We retire Figure Four. That would be great. We're the ones that do it. Take the titles. Beautiful.
Yeah.
But there should be a match. There should be a match April 20th because you're talking 20 years of Jonesy.
That's right.
Right? And I know that it says right in the advertisement, no challenge, but that would be a good fight, you and Jonesy.
Well, it says probably.
Yeah.
I'm kind of leaving it open.
Yeah.
Because that would be really interesting.
I mean, you figure 500 people there, a limousine there, all these prizes there, and it ends with, and we're getting close to WrestleMania. Like, a good Figure Four versus Jonesy would make some good press, I think.
I would actually wonder how that fight would happen. Would it be a musical fight? Would it be an actual physical fight? And if it was physical fight, would it be Jell-O
like
wrestling?
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
would it be...
I don't think you could plan
you
it either.
Plan. Yeah.
But if it is a musical fight, I mean, the audience wins. The audience wins
because you're
talking two of the best bands in Niagara.
Yeah.
You know,
but if it was a music
fight,
how would
music?
You do that? Would you like each play a song and whoever did it better? But because that's really not fair either.
It's tricky.
Because
dance off is usually the way to settle these.
A
things.
Drink
yeah,
off,
dance off,
drink a shot off.
Yeah. Hmm.
Yeah, we had at the last fundraiser on St. Paddy's Day.
Yes.
We had Bob Fisher, who used to play for the Bandits. Mm-hmm. He's like heavily involved and
yeah.
is a big help. And is kind of the fifth official member with yes. his Figure Four tattoo, right?
yeah.
But he got a signed Bandits jersey from all the current players.
Oh, wow.
Oh, nice.
So we had one on stage, his jersey. And I was like, okay, how can I give this away in a fun way? And I'm like, can you do a drink off? You can't really promote drinking that
no.
way. And I
no.
didn't want to do a live auction. Like, we were trying to keep it
yeah.
moving, keep the music going. It's like, oh, we got to do a dance off. So we did an 80s dance off to Footloose and had the stage full of people that freaked out. Jack from Jack Van Ginger and,
right.
yeah.
and Uncle Bobby. Everybody was like, what are you doing? But it was fun.
Oh, I would kill that dance off.
Yeah.
You oh,
got
yeah.
some Kevin Bacon moves or?
Yeah.
Well, you should buy tickets.
You've seen them before. Oh, yeah.
You should buy tickets to the 20th. I think everybody should buy tickets to
I
the 20th.
I think we should be the host.
Who
maybe
comes
we'll
up
another dance off? Yeah.
Who comes good. Up with a Jonesy Figure Four, like that combination? Is it you guys, the band, or is it like the promoter, or who came up with that?
You
because that's
give,
a great combination. To
I got to give credit to the Saxtons. They
okay.
After all their fundraisers, they said the one that did the best was the one that had both us and Jonesy.
Oh.
And so when they were planning another event, they said, "Would you guys be up for doing it together?"
Yes.
And I knew that the guys and Jonesy were celebrating their anniversary, and we were celebrating ours.
Perfect.
And so I reached out, and they're always good to collaborate too. They're great to work with. I actually got to play with three of the five this past weekend too, so it's
okay.
always good to collaborate.
Well, yeah.
There's so many good
okay.
bands and
yeah.
musicians in this
yeah.
community. Like,
so has this really besides that weekend you're talking about, has this ever yeah. happened before, Jonesy Figure Four?
Yes, the one other fundraiser that we did at Taps for No One Goes Hungry,
mm-hmm.
both
okay.
bands were there as well.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like
but,
this.
But that's been a long
time. Take my
time.
Money now. I like this.
Yeah.
It should be good.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's a unique pairing, but they're so...
So who goes first?
...polished and professional and, like,
yeah.
they
well, yeah.
know what they're doing.
Who's on
these
first?
Guys. I don't know. I'm assuming we are because,
okay.
you know, they're the better band. And, you know, they seem like they have more years on us. They're more...
Yeah, they're a great band, absolutely. Yeah. I've seen them a few times.
I couldn't honestly answer the question of who's the better band.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll probably alternate or whatever. I'll leave
right.
it to them.
Yeah.
But,
I don't
yeah,
have a favorite.
Does not matter. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. No, it doesn't matter who's on first.
I know.
Now, how do you come up with that when you come to the band? Because... the songs have got to be different, obviously. The sets
yeah.
have got to be different.
Yeah.
And you guys don't really follow so much
no.
of a set,
a set list,
right?
No.
You have a lot of the crowd guys... calling it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's basically by request only.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
The
yeah.
toughest part for us is probably the load in, load out, and then deciding on the first song.
Yeah.
I would say it's
yeah.
up there with the hardest
And
part.
How do you decide whose drums are being used? Right? Because it's hard to switch those out.
Bernie's not going to let anybody touch his drums.
We're going to have to plan this stuff
I know.
Because
it's easy to switch out guitars.
Yeah.
And
I mean, I don't think that matters. I think that's something to leave to the audience to see that, you know. Yeah, I don't think that matters, but
both Bernie and Rich are both easygoing.
That could be the start of the fight right there. That could be the start of the battle. Yeah. Bernie's not going to let him touch the drums.
It's going to be half and half. Yeah.
How many songs do you actually know? Because that must be hard to know when you're standing on stage and someone's calling out a song and boom, you know it. Like, you must have a category and you've been playing 25 years. Like,
and you'd think I'd know.
Is there anything by now? Maybe an easier question is there? Is there anything that stumps you up? Is there anything?
For sure.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure. We get stumped, and you know, you just gotta. No one hold them, no one to fold them.
Yeah,
right? But just as long as one of us have heard it and have a sense of, you know, how it goes, we'll get a shot, right?
Yeah.
One of us can carry the rest of us through, then we'll go for it.
But, okay, beautiful.
Yeah. And we're not aiming for perfection every time, so you don't have to know it.
Has anyone asked for Beyonce's Texas Hold'em yet?
Not yet, no.
No,
are
that's
you coming
stupid.
On the 20th? Are you going
to
ask
that? No, I would not.
We have
ask
had Beyonce
for
requests for sure.
Have you really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
It's a fun country song. That's all I got to say. I'm not really a country fan, but I like
that. I don't really
but
see Figure 4 doing country.
That's not one I would ask for Figure 4.
No. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't think you can handle that. Yeah, but we're always up for whatever, right? Take the request. So we'll see what Jonesy has on their list, and then we'll avoid.
And then you're opening it. Yeah, that's perfect. Yeah.
I have a question.
Well, what would be interesting before you get to that question is if somebody shouts out the song that Jonesy has on their set list, then what happens? Is that the other start of the fight?
That's one of the fights.
Yeah, that's one of the fights that's going to happen.
You can't play that.
Yeah. There's a lot of potential
for trouble. At this
there could be trouble. Let's start promoting a fight happening between Jonesy and Figure 4. Yeah. But what would the position of you being if you know kind of what's on Jonesy's set list? If you're ahead of Jonesy and somebody yells out a song that's on that set list, are you going to sing it? Or are you going to say...
No.
Okay.
You know how many people...
I would just ignore it. I'll say...
Yes.
Okay.
It's coming. It's coming.
Because
right?
anytime they ask for a request, there's like 80 people all yelling. So you can just avoid that one and pick one of the other ones, and they will never know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't hear you. I heard that one.
Although, in all sincerity, we try our best to get everybody's requests all, right? And if we don't have any chance at it, I'll just tell them. Like, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's,
It's not going to happen. Do you have a second choice?
That's right. So, no, I've seen you do that
before.
But it's
hard to get them all in.
Yeah.
Night,
I know.
Right? So it goes by so fast.
I would say, is it easiest when people shout out a artist name or a band name as opposed to a song?
I don't know, because we have a hard time making decisions, right?
Yes.
So that first song is always the hardest. And then if somebody yells out a band, oh, Tragically Hip or whatever, it's like, oh, do you have a particular Tragically Hip song?
Yeah, which? Right. Yes, there's so many options.
What Van Halen song do you
want to hear?
Yeah, either way, you're kind of screwed, I guess. Yeah. Well, that sucks. Okay.
But it's all part of the fun.
I forgot my question, but now I remember it.
All right.
Okay. The kazoo.
The kazoo, yes.
How did that come about? And did you have to, learn it? Like, I'm pretty sure you don't have to learn it, but
kazoo is kind of like humming or whistling, right?
And yes.
I don't even remember how I started bringing it out. It might have been when I started doing either a solo or a duo, and I needed to replace like a lead guitar line or something. So instead of whistling it, I brought out the kazoo, and just became a thing. And I've got a couple as gifts over the years, so I just keep it in the rotation and try not to use it too often, so that doesn't completely ruin the sex appeal.
I love it.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Kazoo. It's like, everybody needs more cowbell.
Yeah.
You need more kazoo.
Yeah. There a little bit of kazoo is all right. You can't
overdo
it.
Yeah, I guess there is too much kazoo.
Right? It's you can overdo the harmonica.
There are certain parts that... How do you feel that out as to when that is like... Because
it's when our guitarist doesn't know a part. Or it's like, okay, it's time for the kazoo. It's
time for the kazoo. Yeah.
Uncle Bobby and I played a duo gig in the falls recently, and someone requested Hotel California.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
I can't play Hotel California. We don't even have one guitarist up here, never mind like four. But I did it on the kazoo, and it was...
Oh, wow. Yeah. Amazing.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Commercial Roadhouse.
Yeah.
You've been doing some stuff there. Where did that partnership start, or how's that relationship?
So the building itself has been there since 1851, yes. But the Saxons and I purchased it not too long ago, right?
Okay.
So I'm kind of partners with them on the building.
Yes.
And then the guys from 43 North Group are running the restaurant.
Okay.
And then downstairs, we converted into a bit of a speakeasy.
Yes.
Right? So it's this kind of hidden bar vibe atmosphere down there that we're doing a few events down there.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Are you gonna start doing like weekly live music? Like what's...
Well, they do weekly live music upstairs in the Commercial Roadhouse every Saturday night. They have music up there.
Okay.
And then I did a night where it was live music trivia.
Yes.
So it was like...
I remember
kind
that.
Of a little twist, right? Mm-hmm. It's hard to do trivia nights because they're
so
all
many.
Over the place,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people do it really well. Like Lisa Mayer at Romby's, for example.
Yeah.
She's awesome at it, right?
Also Lee Burek from Nagger Name That Tune.
Yeah.
Yes. Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's a bunch of people that do the trivia, right? So,
yes.
I thought, I've never seen anybody do it live.
No.
So I've kind of taken my request thing.
Yeah.
And
that's cool.
Super
that's cool.
So
yeah.
We did a night there and it was super fun.
Yeah.
And then the guys from Mr. Mike's in St. Catharines, they have one in Welland as well.
Yes.
They asked me to do one at Mr. Mike's and it was super fun there too. So it's kind of a new venture, but I don't want to be doing that all the time.
No.
Because then that gets oversaturated.
Once
too.
In a while thing. That's a treat.
Well,
yeah.
once a month.
Yeah, maybe once.
Yeah,
every
I would say a little
so,
less than once a month.
Yeah, but it was like both times was super fun and different, right?
Yeah.
So we did that down there, and then we had a salsa night down there, and
yes.
we had a chamber event down there, and we're doing a comedy series.
Yes.
So cocktails and comedy, and
okay.
so David Green from the Garden City Comedy Festival.
Right? That's right. Yeah.
So he's bringing in a couple of comics actually tomorrow night.
Oh, okay.
One. So yeah.
Well, check that out.
Yeah.
Commercial
guys want to come down?
Yeah.
But we're gonna be doing that the third Thursday of every month.
Comedy night at the Roadhouse.
Yeah. And cocktails too.
Commercial
we do this
Roadhouse.
Jam sesh cocktail.
What did it used to be called?
That's what it's called, isn't it?
It's always been called the Commercial.
Okay.
Yeah. yeah. Since one on the corner there, Ridgeway.
Yeah. That's, and so on Sodom Road.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Commercial Roadhouse. I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Really cool
I've eaten
building.
There before.
Yeah, the food is fantastic.
I'm pretty sure I had it.
I never once
sandwich.
Walked in there, but I know it's always been packed every time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Every time.
It's a great spot.
That's
it's right
cool.
off the highway, yep. and it's...
And it was like, when it closed down, everybody that I talked to that's local in that area, they were like, we were devastated when it closed. And
that's the
so
local
happy.
Hangout.
Like,
when I lived
it
in
was,
Fort
yeah.
Erie, it was always parking lot full. All the people that work in that area or live in that area, that would be the local hangout. The
that or
Roadhouse.
The scuttlebutt. Is really the only place you
sure.
could go.
And they were like, the feedback was, don't change it. You know, don't make it too fancy or too, you know.
It's like a blue collar working man's bar.
Yeah, so, and they're doing a great job with the food there, right? They've got
That's
the
good.
Fantastic pizza and wings and sandwiches and the fish
Beautiful.
And chips. And, you know, it's the tried and true stuff.
Yeah.
But, done well.
Yeah,
right?
That's
yeah, yeah.
good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
Yeah, Commercial
yeah,
Roadhouse.
Yeah. So where do we get more information on what's happening there and all the events?
Commercialspeakeasy.com is the website where you can
and
get
then
tickets. And
is that also for the Commercial Roadhouse to find out?
They have their own website, which is probably commercialroadhouse.com, but it might be thecommercialroadhouse.com. I'm not sure, but it's linked from the Commercial Speakeasy
just Google
well,
it, Commercial Roadhouse,
Google
you'll find it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
well,
beautiful.
I'm just trying to get info
Either
on
way.
Here.
But yeah, thanks for mentioning that.
Yeah.
It's a fun spot. It's kind of it's a cool place.
But
to
you're
be.
For Commercial Speakeasy.
Probably come summertime, we'll probably do something out there again, and I'll likely do another live music trivia at some point. But
now, can you
they
do
have
something
a big,
outside?
I was about to ask that.
Yeah.
They have a big parking lot.
They've got a big parking lot. They've got a big patio.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
So we could do
I don't
some outdoor things.
You know, overpromise anything.
Wrestling?
No, of course not. Yeah.
A figure four wrestling night?
It might be
night?
Tight for wrestling, but, you know.
Outside.
Yeah. Who knows?
Figure
Who knows?
Four wrestling.
Wrestling on the roof.
Yeah.
Maybe not on the roof. That's, no, I'm pretty sure there's no insurance that would ever cover
that. Yeah, that might be the tricky part
for
that.
Yeah.
I don't know. It seems like, I don't remember what the parking lot, I remember it's a good size, but I don't know. Once you get a ring in there and everything, I don't know. I'm open to go check it out, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Wrestling in figure four in the ring.
Sounds
figure
good.
Four in the ring.
Let's go back
yeah.
to Jonesy and figure four.
Yes.
April 20th. It's a Saturday at the Ovation Ballroom. It's in Thorold,
it.
Right off Highway 20406.
Yep.
Fundraiser for No One Goes Hungry. Give a little blurb as to what people are going to expect.
Well, hype them up. Your guess is as good as mine, right?
But so, hype them up.
All these questions that you have.
I mean, I don't think
you have to answer them, but it's going to be both bands and probably a collaboration between the two at some point.
Oh, that would be interesting as well.
See, you were saying I'm stupid for asking him, and now you're just found out another tidbit of information.
I didn't say you're stupid. Yeah, I said, you know, here's some of the questions that Kendra would ordinarily ask a band, like, what's in your set list?
I think you asked that.
You know, yeah. You never ask a band.
But you're the one. You are the one who asked that, though. That's the funny part. I didn't ask that question tonight.
No, I said you get stumped on any songs that get shouted out. I didn't ask.
No, you asked about the set list because they don't. And I was the one who mentioned that they don't actually have set lists because you were wondering about the conflict between them and Jonesy.
I'm just trying to promote a fight here.
Well, we're having a fight right now.
You're ruining the whole promotion.
No, this is perfect.
You're ruining the whole promotion of Jonesy.
We're not.
Maybe one of the fights that
night. I know.
Right?
I'll throw it right off the stage. I don't care about cancel culture. I'll throw it right off the stage.
I've put you in a headlock before. Don't even.
If you guys want to help with the MC duties, that
we would love to.
Yes.
That would be super duper fun.
And start a fight.
Yeah. We'll start a fight. But yeah, that'd be a great collaboration. Like you say, Jonesy and Figure Four doing something together.
Yeah.
Would be
again.
Cool. Yeah.
And the tricky part again will be deciding on what songs. I have no idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
you guys are going to play it by ear.
Whatever, yeah.
You know what? That's what you've always done for 25 years. Yeah. Just shout out the song and you're either getting it or you're not. 90% of the time you'll get it. Maybe 80% of the time you'll get it.
The essence of it.
Yeah, the essence of it. Or part
and
of
it.
Done
is
in Figure
always
Four
the
style.
Best. Even when you guys are like, oh, you know, we don't really know it, but we're going to try it for you.
Yeah.
It is the best experience because everybody that's in the audience is loving what you guys are doing, but are also have such a full heart for the fact that you're trying.
Giving it a try.
Because not many bands would try that. And
or
the
is
fact
it like
that
watching a train wreck, I don't know.
No, it's not.
No, the party never dies when you have Figure Four on stage.
No.
That's the thing. The
because
party never dies.
Even when you mess even if you mess it up.
Yep.
No, I didn't say that. Yeah.
Even
yeah.
if you mess it up. Everybody is enjoying the fact that you're putting yourselves out there and at least trying, putting effort in for the people who are listening.
Right.
Well, I appreciate it. Yeah, I mean, like that's our thing, right?
Yeah.
Perfection is not the goal.
No.
It's the interaction. It's the fun. It's just.
I'd have to say you guys are pretty close to perfection, though.
I got a little bit of an offbeat question because we've seen Figure Four. We know what you're about, but what do you listen to? What is your favorite?
I, okay, so. It's very similar to a Figure Four show where it's all over the map.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it's kind of cliche, but I kind of listen to a bit of this and a bit of that.
Yeah,
so
do I.
I have my favorites, and it depends on the mood I'm in, right? So whether it's like the Rage Against the Machine stuff that I love, and like
me too.
Poison was my favorite band growing up.
Me too, yeah.
Also like Weird Al Yankovic. You know, it's like goes from one extreme to the next. Willie Nelson, you know?
Yeah.
But my family makes fun of me because the music that I listen to at home often is slow and sad, and they think I'm so depressed.
You're kidding
my
me.
My playlist is like slow and sad.
I
but I don't like playing
that
stuff. I like listening to it. But,
right.
Like,
because it, like,
live,
does it,
I love belting
does it
stuff
relax
out,
you,
right?
though? I would think the slow and maybe melancholy is kind of like a just like it's almost a release of relaxation.
Yeah, maybe.
You know,
I just,
like those sound boys.
For whatever reason. I'm
or is it that
you've
heard and play this stuff so much that you just need something different every now and again?
Well, there's no way I'm going home and listening to like Sweet Child of Mine or something. I just can't do it. You know, if there's a song
right.
that you've played a million times or heard a million
That's
times,
right.
I'm not intentionally putting it on. So,
Yeah.
I don't mind playing it.
Yeah,
know, so
right.
I
request it, and I know it means a lot, that song, to
sure.
a couple people I know personally, right? So I'll always play it, but it's like, and I don't dislike that song, but
it's
I'd
interesting.
Rather, we tried Welcome to the Jungle for the first time.
Oh, really?
Just recently. And
the first time you've never done Welcome to the Jungle before?
No, and then we opened up with it at the St. Patty's Day fundraiser. I'm like, why don't we open with the one that we don't really know?
Like, that would be in,
it's
oh, wow.
It's like a high wire act, right? Yeah.
And that's a long song, too. I mean, if you don't know it,
well,
you know, you have to cut out halfway through and
now
do
we got
something
through,
else.
I mean, it's one of those songs that you know, right? You know where it's going.
For sure,
If you have someone like a Nick Parisotto carrying you through, and Bruce is, of course, going to know it, and Rob and I will follow along.
Yeah.
Is your family ever embarrassed of what you do.
How dare you?
Oh, probably. I would imagine so. Especially the kids, like, teenage kids. So. Yeah. They've never said that to me, but my daughter, her grade 8 graduation is coming up. And one of her buds, her mom is one of the owners of Rombies.
Okay.
And she was like, what do you think about, like, playing their grade 8 graduation? I'll bring the band in. I'm like,
absolutely not. Like, there's no way. I could not do that to my daughter.
Slider it is.
She would hate it, but the kids would be like, oh my gosh, like, this know. Is.
Yeah.
Then again, I'm not really, like, my son is 24 now, so, and I know he would like those songs, but I don't know about the next generation down from that.
But if it was you singing those songs, yeah. would he like it? You know, it's different,
no.
right?
No. Yeah. When I was, like, on doing, like, the Your TV and all that kind of stuff, yeah. like, his friends would say stuff, and he would be like, yeah, he hated that. He would never talk to me about it.
Yeah, I think it's there's, you know, really cool people in the world, yes. and the person that thinks they're the least right. cool is likely their kids,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah. That's 100%.
Wherever you think of their kids, yeah. yeah. But
what about your wife, though? Is she ever like,
she's probably
my...
the same way, right? It's like, yeah.
He's out doing his thing again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she comes out every once in a while, and yeah. it's fun, and we have a good time, but she's not coming out to every
yeah.
day.
Like, yeah.
Been there, done that.
She's yeah. like, every time he comes home, I gotta shrink that hen, because he's just got such a big hen.
You know, yeah. and my girlfriend came to one wrestling event, and that's all I had, one wrestling yeah. event, and then now that's
down.
All over with, yeah. and, you know,
put
we've seen it, we looked at it, I'm not going back, yeah.
So what'd you think? Uh-huh.
Right? Okay. Yes, that's exactly it, yeah.
So what else are you doing with your time these days?
Oh,
where else
man,
are you?
I'm just trying to keep my head above water these days. It's like just constant. You know, I'm on the treadmill of life, right?
Yeah.
As I'm sure we all are with the to-do list and all kinds of yeah. fun stuff. But I don't know. I'm just every day trying to do good stuff with good people. And so far, so good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it. I like the t-shirts. Oh, mine fell down.
Yeah, right on.
Yeah. Going to same
yeah,
party
I
for 25 years.
All the trouble of getting merch and brought
every
it to
minute.
The fundraiser and like
yeah.
nobody
and
bought
it. Will this stuff will it be available at
yeah,
that
yeah.
one?
It's available actually online with the tickets for the fundraiser.
Okay.
We got shot glasses as well as the other
oh, beautiful.
Piece of merchandise.
Yeah.
That was
well, you don't drink anymore. So.
I would have thought of the kazoos, but
yeah.
shot
glasses. Yeah, that would have worked too.
But then again, imagine you had a whole bunch of people in the audience with your kazoo. And they just
well Jack Van Ginger tried to do that actually at the fundraiser. It was
okay.
a great idea. He threw out a bunch of kazoos for everybody to play during all one
right.
part of I think Brown Eyed Girl.
Okay.
As kind of instead of sing along, play the kazoo, and nobody knew how to play the kazoo.
Yeah, I could only imagine.
Okay, everybody on the count of three, and then it was.
And like the amount of people who have had like so many drinks that they're just like,
yeah, and they're still trying to get the plastic out of it, and, yeah, blowing into
the
it,
noise
and,
yeah. is just them breathing
how,
into
how
it.
How was the Hooligans to play with? Because I would think oh, that was a great show as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Again, like there's so many good bands in the area,
I know.
And it's a very non-competitive landscape. Like everybody's pretty supportive.
Yes,
you know, one of the guys from the Hooligans was at that last show, and
yeah.
you know, we try to go. Not that I get out much when I'm not playing,
yeah.
but we all try to get out and support each other, and that's why it's kind of fun to do these gigs together because
yes.
we don't get to see each other, or
yeah.
play with each other.
Yeah,
so,
there must be a bunch of bands out there that you haven't seen. Like even the Hooligans, have you seen them before? You
yes,
played with them?
I had seen them
okay.
before, and I actually they helped me out in a pinch recently. I was in the Falls again at what's the name of the brewery out there? Blackburn.
Okay.
I was all at right. Blackburn yeah. for a party, and I broke a string, and I only had my acoustic. All my gear was in Bernie's truck,
oh,
so
no.
I was like, oh no, I need a string, I need a guitar.
Yeah.
And so I was like looking up who lives in the Falls, who can I call, and I saw they were playing at Chips. So
okay.
I walked in Chips, and they're like, hey, Mike, what's going on?
Beautiful.
Can I steal your guitar? And Rick was kind enough to give me his Les Paul guitar.
Oh, wow.
Which
okay.
is like
yeah.
not
yeah.
a cheap guitar.
Yeah.
No. And like, I know how I am with my guitar
yeah.
and
right.
most people are, right?
You don't mess with a Les Paul.
And Mark was like, are you sure you want to give it to him? And Rick was like, yeah, I know he'll take good care of him.
Yeah.
I'm like, buddy, I'll take care of it better
yeah.
than I would my own.
Well, you're
yeah.
not.
That
you're
was
not
super
some
nice and helpful.
Tom,
well,
Dick, and Harry with it. He knows that, and you
yeah,
know that.
Exactly. And I've seen the Hooligans
sure.
break strings all the time, like every
well,
show.
Yeah.
So he probably
yeah.
has a bunch of strings at least.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They got to change them every set.
Yeah.
I didn't smash it at the end of the show, though.
No,
that's good. That's good. You don't want
to
be.
He should have said this is Slash's Les Paul that he gave it to me, and then it would have been
like
yeah.
I'm wondering, like the whole smashing guitars, during shows, feasibly, financially.
Yeah. I can't imagine. I can't imagine doing it intentionally.
Yeah.
It's happened before, not intentionally.
And like, and when it happens, is it more of like, I just broke it, so I'm just going to really break it? Well, is that essentially the thought behind it?
Not to throw anybody under the bus, but I've had two people break my Les Paul.
You're kidding me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that must piss you off. And I won't throw
one
under the
bus because one of them's my mom. Sorry, mom. But obviously by accident,
get this piece of shit out of here. Get it out of my house.
She put up with the drums in the basement for years and then she's going to break the guitar.
Right.
I think so.
Yeah.
No, yeah. And then another one was James Moore, right? Who's another guitarist that plays with us. And he's coming back for the summer, so he might sit in with us for a couple shows. He's living in Ireland now, right?
Okay.
But he knocked it over accidentally too, and it was maybe this far away, the crack.
Ooh.
And Freddie's frets was able to fix it twice, which was amazing. So
okay. So you never had an actual, like, I'm going to slam my guitar on stage?
I think I'm about to do it.
Yes.
But I don't think anybody believes it. Yeah.
Okay. Because I think I've seen that happen, like, in a local show. And I'm like, I'm like, okay, if you're going to do that, is it because it's already broken? You want a new one, so I'm just going to smash it even more for the whole theatrics of it?
I guess so. I don't know. I'm not that punk or
because,
hardcore.
Because would you really want to hurt your guitar like that? Unless you're a millionaire, like these big bands, and can just do that every show.
Yeah.
Because they have five others lined up.
To each their own, and maybe you can get a cheap guitar and do it if you're doing it for the theatrics, but
But how do you switch that out?
It's never been my thing. I don't know. Maybe I'll smash a kazoo next show. I can maybe afford to do that.
There you go.
Yeah.
Get a wooden one, because that would be easier to break, right?
Yeah,
or would a plastic? Because a plastic one would just smush.
The worst is when they fall on the ground, the kazoo, and then I'll pick it up and sometimes I'll put it right back in my mouth.
Oh, but it's been like
5 second.
And Bobby will always be like, "What are you doing?"
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. That because I can only imagine in a bar. But at least if you're on a stage, it's not too bad. At least it's just your own beer that you've been spilling on the ground.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, you want to be poisoned by your own Jägermeister.
That's right. Yeah,
germs. Yeah,
100%.
Yeah.
Well, when the adrenaline's going and you got the 5 second rule.
But Bobby's still there. What are you doing?
Yeah.
That was on the ground.
That's as hardcore as we get. Is that's picking it. Up a kazoo off the floor. Yeah.
Putting it back in your mouth.
Now that's rock and roll.
Oh my
Beautiful.
Goodness.
Yeah.
That's
hilarious. But yeah, we love what we do, and you know, you've met the guys in the band, and they're all good dudes. So
yeah, we love it too. We've always loved Figure Four, and 25 years strong, and we're gonna keep on going till the wheels fall off with Figure Four and Jonesy, a good 20 years. So you're talking 45 years of a performing here in Niagara between these two bands, April 20th.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ovation Ballroom.
Yeah.
Saturday, April 20th. Doors are open at 7. Show starts at 8.
Yeah, now where do you get tickets for this baby?
Well, I see at eventbrite.ca you can get tickets.
Yeah.
Yep.
But is there anywhere else that you can get tickets?
I think they have it listed on Ovation Ballroom's site as well as Feastivities, which is another arm of their business.
Okay. So,
but Eventbrite is where you'll end up anyway. And even from Facebook, if you go to the event page on Facebook, it'll lead you to Eventbrite to just get
and
the
Ovation
online.
Ballroom
and
is.
And the Saxons have hard copy tickets as well. So if you wanted to Paul or Mark or Carrie from No One Goes Hungry, she has a stack of tickets. Oh, I should also mention, too, that Carrie is looking for sponsors of the show.
Okay.
So if you are a local business and want to sponsor the show and get tickets and on-site presence, that a sponsorship is available as well.
Beautiful.
It's limited capacity.
Yeah.
So you want to get those tickets now. It's April 20th, so you have... And today is the 20th, so you have 1 month today. 1 month,
yeah. Which, what a party to open up with, like, the spring kind of. I know today is the first day of spring, but the good weather is going to be...
Yesterday was actually the first day of spring.
The good weather is going to be April 20th, and 500 people, because that's what we're going to get, 500 tickets sold to this baby.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
No doubt about it.
Jonesy, Figure Four.
Guaranteed, yeah.
And a good fight going on. So
good fight. A bunch of fights. Maybe they even do like dueling guitars, dueling drums.
You're selling too much here.
I'm not selling. I'm just having options. these are just all these things that could possibly happen. Right. We don't know what's going to happen.
Right. I know what's going to happen. These are just possibilities. We're going to get some solid music from two damn good bands and
at a great place for a great cause. Because no one goes hungry is a great cause.
That's right.
They're feeding so many people. We had them at Club 55 to do a fundraiser.
Now, are they asking food donations as well for No One Goes Hungry, or is it just
will they
monetary?
Have any snack? We should
it's
ask
a
them
good
that.
Question. Yeah. Yeah. Not that I'm aware of. I believe it's just the cash donations. Okay. Yes. But I think if anybody brought food donations, it wouldn't go to waste.
No. Yeah.
So that's especially that's a good snacks. Idea. We can always add that. It always goes to a good place. And if they can't use it, the Niagara Peninsula Foundation for Children that we did the last fundraiser for, I know they can always use it, or community care will find a good home for it anyway if you do have food donations to
So that's
as well.
Perfect. Yes. Yeah, that's absolutely perfect. But for sure, to get into this, $25, that's the ticket price. And go on Eventbrite and check that out.
Mm-hmm.
Figure Four and Jonesy, baby, April 20th. I'm going to be there. I'm going
to
rock
I'm
that
hoping
place.
To be there. I want to be there. We should be there.
Yeah, I hope you guys are there.
Yes.
Can run the
I
show
miss
for us.
Some
and then
figure four.
We'll figure out what we're doing.
We'll figure it out.
Introduce
babe.
What we're going to do, and we'll just do it.
Beautiful.
And we'll have our own fight. Maybe I'll bring a pie.
Bring your t-shirt launcher. We'll launch them out to the crowd.
I don't have one. That would be awesome, though. But we're not giving away t-shirts for free because we're selling them. Well, we're not. Figure Four is selling them.
Yeah.
Yeah, at a hefty, hefty premium.
Hey, those shirts are worth it.
Oh, yeah.
Those shirts are worth it. Yeah.
You can rep in some Figure Four.
They're gold-plated like this microphone. This is a fancy mic. I like it.
It looks fancy, but it's not actually fancy. Okay. One last time. Jonesy, Figure Four. Fundraiser for No One Goes Hungry. Anniversary party for Jonesy and pretty much Figure Four.
Yeah, they had their anniversary, actually, St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
Was
their 20th, yeah.
Oh, nice.
So I got to play with Jack Van Ginger and Paul Reed, and then Scott Nielsen came up and sang a song with us, too. So it was kind of cool to help celebrate on that actual day.
Yeah.
But it'll be even better to
have a big party,
the full band.
Like the actual full party on.
Absolutely.
I've never seen Jonesy outside of
Joe
Blow.
Wait, hold on a second.
Oh, Joe Blow's?
That's what they always do, Joe Blow's anniversary.
April 20th. That's 420.
420. Okay. Well,
that's on 420.
That's right.
April 20th, Saturday, April 20th.
Well, can't forget that.
420 party.
Yeah.
Anniversary party. Fundraiser for No One Goes Hungry. Oh my gosh, it couldn't get better.
And all Bob Marley set.
Yeah. All right. With the kazoo. Yes.
That'd be awesome. I love it. Yeah, Ovation
it should
Ballroom.
Be fun. Yeah, thanks very much.
Make sure you guys get your tickets.
Can I say thank you to you guys, too, for having me here?
Oh, and we love it, man. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
The community and the live music scene
you.
And everything. You guys, you have the same passion for music and all that.
Yeah,
events,
we love
so
it. We love promoting events and No One Goes Hungry and the fundraisers. We love doing that. And, we're on the same page as Figure Four, man. Anything we could do for the community, that's what we do, and that's why we're here, and we're doing this today, and that's why Michael Chess is here in the studio with us, because we are putting it out there to Niagara.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it. All right, let's go to a song, and I'm picking the song, because I like to. And
is it Bob Marley?
No, it's not.
It should be Bob Marley.
It's a local band. It's a local band, because we play local mostly on here.
Love it.
It's Street Pharmacy.
So again? You always play Street Pharmacy.
No, I don't. I haven't played them in forever. I don't actually have one on or played on the podcast, so I'm going to say this is a new one.
Okay.
For us.
Sure.
Sober State of Fame, Street Pharmacy.
Across
Dark City Panic, Adrenalize.
Sounds good. Sounds damn good. Yes. Yeah.
Let's get to some events.
All right.
You start them off, sir.
All right. Excuse me. Going in a little overtime here. Laugh In at the Lions. That's happening Friday at 7 o'clock at the Grantham Lions. Port Weller Residents Association presents second annual Laugh In at the Lions, a night of professional stand-up featuring MC David Green, headliner Ian Serrata, Crystal Fourier, and Jimmy England, $20 in advance, 19 plus admission. Buy tickets at Laugh In at the Lions, eventbrite.com, March 22nd at Grantham Lions Club. Doors at 7 o'clock, comedy at 8 o'clock.
Friday at 3:30 p.m. at Market Square in St. Catharines, there's a family fun market, 3:30 to 9:30 p.m. It's going to be a whole bunch of stuff. Show some love and support to our local community. Free entry, indoor event filled with amazing handmade products and local businesses wanting to show off their products. Free admission, lots of parking, 3:30, 9:30, 91 Kin Street, St. Catharines, mid-afternoon to early evening, handmade crafts, woodworks, jewelry, candles, soap, snacks, and treats, so much to see, one-of-a-kind products you don't want to miss out on.
This one's going to be interesting. Whiskey tasting at the historic Navy Hall. This is happening Saturday at 7 o'clock. Navy Hall, that's at 305 Ricardo Street in Niagara-on-the-Lake. Friends of Fort George, in partnership with 40 Creek Distilleries, which is going to be great, is hosting the fourth annual whiskey tasting events at the historic Navy Hall, hosted by 40 Creek North American brand ambassador Chris Thompson, paired with extensive hors d'oeuvres. There will be several different award-winning 40 Creek whiskey samples provided. Tickets for this event are on sale now. The ticket costs are $50 per person, which is a damn good price for this, and includes food and whiskey samples. Come relax by the warm fire at Navy Hall and enjoy a unique evening of food, drink, whiskey education, and Miramont. Call the Friends of Fort George at 905-468-6621 or email admin@friendsoffortgeorge.ca for more information. Everything's on the Hittin' the 12 events page if you miss all that, or yes, just rewind it on the podcast.
I've got an event that has a whole bunch of information that is too much to give here, so make sure you go to our Hittin' events page so that you can click on the event and get all the information. This Saturday, 1 p.m. to 10 p.m. at the Niagara Falls Convention Center is the 2024 Niagara, Ontario iHeart Beer and Taco Festival. So you're going to have a beer and taco time, 19 plus event tokens be purchased with your tickets, cash only at the event. There's 3 ATMs on site, no free funds on tickets. It's a 1-day event with 2 sessions. If you don't like beer, there are plenty of non-beer options like cider and spirits. So check out that information. Beer sample sizes are 5 ounces. Average sample cost is 1 token. Coat check is available. The breweries, Bayside Brewing, Top Dog Brewing, Paniza Brewing, a whole bunch of places. There's going to be board games, hot sauce sampling, people watching filtered water stations, cup rinsing stations, a whole beer pong area, cup coloring stations. That's going to be crazy. 90s dance party. Make sure you check that out.
A lot of information here that's going to be on the Hittin' 12 events page as well. The Peking Acrobats. Tuesday, 26th of March at 7:30. They push limits of human ability, defying gravity with amazing displays of confrontation, flexibility, and control. The Peking Acrobats are often accompanied by live musicians who skillfully play traditional Chinese instruments. The first honored Chinese music colossus, whatever that means, with high-tech special effects and awe-inspiring acrobat feats, creating an exuberant entertainment event with the festive pageantry of a Chinese carnival. I don't know who wrote that, but
that's a mouthful.
As tired as I am, I mean, that was a hard one. So yes, go to the Hittin' events, I'm ready to pack it in. The Peking Acrobats. Tuesday, the 26th of March at 7:30 at Partridge Hall, First Ontario Performing Arts Center on St. Paul Street in St. Catharines. Get your tickets at firstontariopac.ca and check all that out.
I have one more event. This is actually happening on Sunday. It's the Niagara Mental Health and Wellness Fair happening at the Niagara Falls Exchange, which is 5943 Sylvia Place in Niagara Falls. It's been 2 years since they've had this, but they are running again this Sunday, March 24th, 11 a.m. to 4 p.m., the new artist venue, Niagara Falls Exchange. It's going to be an enriching experience with a diverse array of activities featuring over 20 health and wellness vendors and resources. Attendees can engage with live art demonstrations by esteemed local artists, including Emily Andrews, Sarah Carter, and Heather Fraser, and M. Grote. Live musical performances by Evan Rotella, Electric Wildlife, Nicole Samanara from Gin. And there's also going to be all the vendors and face painting, healthy cooking demonstrations. And of course, there's going to be a whole bunch of speakers. So make sure you check that out. Again, all the information on all these events and more is right on the Hitting the 12 events page. Yes. So make sure you get down into that and make sure you engage in all of what Niagara has to offer.
Offer. Yeah.
Are you ready? It's time for the live music listing.
Live music listings in the clubs here in Niagara for Friday and Saturday. I'll start with Friday, the 22nd of March. Moonlight Company at the Angel Inn. The Sebrings. We'll be at the Repos. Joe Lavoie at the local Shindig. They're going to be at Chip and Charlie's. Strange Tendency at Golden Brothers. Big Shiny Tunes. You can catch them at Cat's Caboose. Danny Boys. They'll be at the Irish Harp. Stuck in the 90s. They'll be at Southside's. Gin at Doc McGilligan's. Maple Jam at the Spice Lounge. LMT Connection is back at Lucky's. Retromatics will be at Pitchers. Something Country at Big Texas. Barefoot in the Kitchen at Putty's, and that's it for Friday. Check out the rest at the Hit the 12 events page.
That's okay. That's okay. We have a lot going on.
A lot of music.
Yeah. This Saturday, the 23rd, Jasmine Tea is at the Regency. Whiskey Glasses at Warehouse. Black Wire at Pitchers. Black Sheep at Chip and Charlie's. Vinyl Flux at Cat's Caboose. Jack Van Ginger at the Irish Harp. Breakfast Club at Doc McGilligan. Silverado at Big Texas. Funhouse at Pitchers. The Well Well Wells at Ollie's. Patsy and the Muscle at the Feathery. Whiskey Rattlers at the Angel Inn. Secondhand News at Parker's. Pub House. Maple Jam at the Reeb House. Hard Rock Hooligans at Joe Blow's. Funhouse at Putty's. Uncle Fester's at Golden Brothers. And Neon Dirty at the Place.
Wow, that's a lot of music for Friday and Saturday here in Niagara. That we must have just named off over 20 bands playing at 20 different venues here in Niagara. We are locked and loaded with live music happening Friday and Saturday here in Niagara. Shout out to Michael Chess, man. Thank you very much for coming in.
April 20th.
Super excited. We're going to be there, and we're going to welcome Jonesy to the stage as well as Figure Four. Yeah. And we are pumped up for that. So we're going to have a lot of that listed throughout the next 4 weeks.
Yeah.
On the Hitting the 12 events page. Everything that's an event here in Niagara is on the Hitting the 12 events page. And you can post your event there as well.
And we'll of course, post a copy of this episode any day now.
Yeah.
So that you can hear again.
Yeah. So, again, shout outs to the boys, Jonesy's, shout out to Figure Four, shout outs to Michael Chess, and we're going to have a good time. And
No one goes hungry.
No one goes hungry, baby, and get all the information. I don't know. My throat's done. I'm done. Little K, is there anything else?
No, we just want to say thanks for listening.
Yeah, we'll be back next Wednesday live here on 4680Q, 8 o'clock Wednesday. That's when we do our show, and hey, what more can I say? I'm Infamous Jay Moore.
I'm Little K Kendra.
And we are Hitting the 12. 12.